Hello, this video was created by Vinay Bellare, a senior information developer at BMC Software, and narrated by a computer-generated voice. In this video, we'll see how you can manage credentials and vaults in BMC Discovery. For credentials, we'll cover how credentials are managed and how you can add, edit, and test credentials. For vaults, we'll see how to set and clear the vault passphrase, close and open the vault, and export and import the vault. A credential is typically a username and a password for a host system that helps authenticate the user's login identity. To discover data in your IT environment, BMC Discovery requires login access to host systems. A BMC Discovery appliance stores credentials in its secure vault. To see the credentials held on your appliance, go to the Manage menu and click Credentials. If you have a registered BMC Discovery outpost, and you specify the outpost in the Discovery scan scope, the appliance sends a request to the outpost to scan the IP addresses. The outpost accesses the target by using the credentials held in its own encrypted vault. The outpost credentials are listed below the appliance credentials. An appliance and an outpost hold credentials in their respective vaults. Credentials are not shared between vaults. The targets are accessed by using different methods, such as SSH, Telnet, WMI, and SNMP. You can also use REST APIs to discover device types. If you have the required access privileges, you can add credentials. Let's see how this is done. On the credentials page, click Add. We see several credential types categorized into groups, such as network devices or databases. As an example, we'll see how to add credentials for a Windows system. You can use the same process to add other credential types. Under Host, click Windows. In the Label field, specify a unique name that helps you identify the credential. Optionally, if you want to add more credential types of the same group, you can easily add by clicking the plus icon here. For example, click WeCenter. You'll see that the fields of this new type are automatically added to the bottom of the screen. For now, we'll cancel WeCenter. Enter the remaining field values, such as the target system's username and password. Click Apply to save the credential. The newly added credential appears here. You can edit, test to delete, or disable the credential from this Actions menu. If you need to edit credentials, that's easy. You first need to search for the specific credential. To do this, you can select one or more checkboxes for the credential category you want to list, such as host or database. Or, click the list for a credential category and select the checkboxes for a specific type. For example, to edit WeCenter credentials, click the host list and select the WeCenter checkbox. Or, enter a specific IP address or search text in this text box and click Apply. From the displayed result list, click Actions for the item you want to edit. Select Edit, update the credential, and then save it. You can test the credentials in different ways to ensure that BMC Discovery is able to access those specific IP addresses. Identify the credential you want to test, and from its Actions menu, click Test. Enter the required fields, and click Test. The Test tab displays the result. Another way is that if you want to rerun a test, click Retry for that test from the Actions column. Or, to run a test for an arbitrary IP address, click Test IP Access, enter the IP address, and then click Test. Note that editing or testing of credentials held on the outpost is allowed only on the outpost, not on the appliance. Let's now understand the credential vault. The appliance credentials are stored in a vault that is encrypted with a 512-bit passphrase. The outpost vault is encrypted with a generated passphrase when the outpost registers with an appliance. If you add, remove, or change a credential, the vault is backed up. If you add, remove, or change the vault passphrase, all vault backups are deleted. This ensures that backups of potentially less secure vaults are not retained in the system. We strongly recommend that you use the default vault to avoid access issues due to an incorrect passphrase. However, if you need to set the vault passphrase, then go to the administration page and click Vault Management. Click Set Passphrase. Enter the new passphrase and enter once again to confirm. If you select this checkbox, your new passphrase will be saved so that you don't have to enter it every time a Discovery scan begins. Click Apply. Let's now see what we mean by an open or closed vault. If you have not set a passphrase or if you set a passphrase and opt to save it, then the vault is opened automatically when BMC Discovery starts. And when BMC Discovery stops, the vault is automatically closed. But if you have set a passphrase and not saved it, then you will be prompted to enter it every time Discovery begins. To close the vault, it must be open and have the passphrase set. Click Close the Vault. You are requested to confirm the operation. To open a closed vault, click Open the Vault. You are requested to confirm the operation. And click Apply. You have an extremely useful option of backing up your credential vault. You can use this feature when you are moving an outpost from one server location to another. To export the vault, go to the Manage menu and click Credentials. Click Export and enter a passphrase of a minimum of 8 characters. Click Export again. An encrypted JSON file is automatically downloaded. To successfully import the encrypted credential vault into your system, click Import. Click Choose File and select the JSON file. Enter the passphrase you had set earlier during the export. Optionally, select this checkbox if you want the credentials from the imported file to overwrite the existing credentials in your vault. Click Import. After the process completes, the imported credentials are listed here. BMC Discovery also allows you to use credentials stored in a credential broker, which is application software that manages credentials. Currently, BMC Discovery supports BeyondTrust Password Safe, Centrify Identity Platform, CyberArk Credential Provider, and Thycotic Secret Server. In a subsequent video, we'll see how you can use some of these brokers. You've just seen how BMC Discovery manages credentials and vaults. For more information on this topic, see the BMC Online Documentation Portal. Thanks for watching.